गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स ई होप यू आर आल सेफ एट होम सो इन लास्ट क्लास वी रिवाइज्ड द मंथली पोर्शन टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द एक्सरसाइज 3.2 ओके सो इन दिस एक्सरसाइज वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट हाउ टू फाइंड द एंगल बिटवीन द लाइन्स हू स्लोप्स आर गिवन ओके हू स्लोप्स आर गिवन मीन्स हियर टू स्लोप्स आर गिवन सो वी अप्लाई द फॉर्मुला फॉर स्लोप दैट इज tan theta equal to m1 minus m2 divided by 1 plus m1 m2 okay modulus of so we are applying these formulas in order to find the angle between the lines whose slopes are 1 by 2 and 3 that is here there are two slopes are given one is m1 and another one is m2 okay so m1 equal to 1 by 2 and m2 equal to 3 let theta be the angle between the given lines here tan theta equal to modulus of m1 minus m2 divided by 1 plus m1 m2 that is we are applying the formula tan theta tan theta is nothing but slope so whenever they are asking about slopes you apply these formulas that is tan theta equal to m1 minus m2 divided by 1 plus m1 m2 okay so tan theta equal to here m1 the value of m1 is 1 by 2 and the value of m2 equal to 3 therefore 1 by 2 minus 3 divided by 1 plus m1 into m2 means 1 by 2 into 3 okay so in numerator and denominator we are taking 2 as LCM so in numerator if you take 2 as LCM 1 minus 6 that is 2 3s are 6 so we are getting minus 5 by 2 and in denominator after taking the LCM we are getting plus 5 by 2 while we are after cancelling 5 by 2 we are getting minus 1 So if you take modulus, then we are getting plus 1, okay? So therefore tan theta equal to plus 1. So the value of 45 degree, theta equal to 45 degree, tan 45 equal to 1. Therefore theta equal to 45 degree, okay? So this is the way you have to find the angle between the lines. When the two slopes are given, apply the formula tan theta equal to modulus of m1 minus m2. Divided by 1 plus m1 m2 okay next we are going to see the second sum find the distance of the point 4, 1 from the line 3x minus 4y plus 12 equal to 0 so the first formula is relating to slopes here they are asking the distance of the point one point is given and one line is given so we are finding the distance between this point and the line okay so if point and line is given we are applying the following formula that is distance of the point x1 comma y1 from the line ax plus by plus c equal to 0 is modulus of ax1 plus by1 plus c divided by root of a square plus b square okay here the distance of the point is 4, 1 that is the point given is 4, 1 and the line is 3x minus 4y plus 12 okay here we are applying the values of a that is the a equal to 3 that is coefficient of x is taken as a and y is taken as b and c is 12 constant is 12 so now from in this line 3x minus 4y plus 12 equal to 0 I am substituting the value of x and y as the point that is given 4, 1 okay so substitute these points in the line 3x minus 4y plus 12 we are getting 3 into 4 minus 4 into 1 plus 12 divided by here the value of a equal to 3 and the value of b equal to 4 that is the coefficient of x is a and the coefficient of y is b therefore 3 square plus 4 minus 4 square we are getting 25 root of 25 becomes 5 Likewise, 3/4 are 12 in numerator. 3/4 are 12 minus 4 plus 12. We are getting 20. 20 by 5. So if you cancel 20 by 5, we are getting 4. So modulus of 4 is 4. Therefore, distance equal to 4 units. That is, from the point 4, 1 and the line 3x minus 4y plus 12, the 4 unit is taken as a distance. Okay. Now, so first we apply the formula. Theta tan theta equal to m1 minus m2 divided by 1 plus m1 m2 here we are applying the second formula one point and line is given you are apply this formula ax1 plus by1 plus c divided by root of a square plus b square then third case show the straight line here there are three straight lines are there. They said that it is concurrent. So if they are concurrent, we are finding the value of the determinants, which is zero. Okay. So for example, here the first equation is x plus y minus 4. Here take the coefficient of xy. Xy equal to 1 minus 4. Take write it as the condition for the lines to be concurrent is 1 minus 4. 3x, that is 3x means 3. Y term is 0. Therefore put 0 in second row. And 2 take it as a 2. 3 minus 3 16 in third equation. So if you find determinants of these values, in first chapter you are already learned about the matrix, how to find the determinants of the matrix. Here also, by expanding the R1, we are getting the values 42 minus 42 equal to 0. That is, determinants of the matrix equal to 0 means the lines are concurrent. So you have to prove the value of the determinants is 0, then the lines are concurrent. That is the rule. So if the three lines are given, you if they ask to prove that it is concurrent, in such case you have to find the determinants of the matrix and which is 0. Okay, so if it is 0 means then it is concurrent, otherwise it is not concurrent. Okay, then now we are going to see the next sum. Find the value of A for which the straight line 3x plus 4y equal to 13, 2x minus 7y equal to minus 1, and ax minus y minus 14 are equal to 0 are concurrent. Okay, listen, here also they said that the three equations are concurrent. In such a case, we are finding the values of the determinants. But here in third equation, A is given. That is, coefficient of x is taken as A. We have to find the A by applying the same rule here. That is, the if the given lines are concurrent means the determinants of the matrix is 0. I am applying the same rule in order to find the value of A. For example, here 3, 4, minus 13, first row, second row, 2, minus 7, 1. And third row it is A minus 1 minus 14. Okay, so here if you find the determinants by expanding the R1, we are getting 435 equal to 87A. Okay, so now find the value of A by dividing a 435 by 87 and getting 5 as answer. Okay, so these two sums, that is third and fourth sums, are same, but in third sum you have to prove that it is concurrent by finding the value of the determinants equal to 0. Here we are finding the value of A. It is said that they are concurrent means the value of determinants is 0 means I am finding the value of A by taking the A value as one side. Okay, the next sum. A manufacturer produces 80 TV sets at a cost of 2,20,000. Okay, and 125 TV sets at a cost of 2,87,500. Assuming the cost curve to be linear, find the linear expression of the given information. Also estimate the cost of 95 TV. Okay, here they said that the manufacturer produces how many TV here? 80 TV sets. So take 80 as X1. Okay, the cost is Y. Take a cost as Y. That is Y1 equal to 2,20,000. Likewise, in second case, it is said that 125 TV sets cost is 2,87,500. Here this 125 implies the X2 and 2,87,500 implies the Y2. So we are having 2 points, that is X1, Y1, X2 and Y2. So now if we are having 2 points means apply the 2 point formula. So already you learned in 10th itself the 2 point formula, that is the equation of the statement representing the given information as a linear expression in x and y is y minus y1 divided by y2 minus y1 equal to x minus x1 divided by x2 minus x1. Here write y as it is. y1 is 2,30,000 and y2 is 2,87,500 and y1 is minus 2,20,000. Then equal to y minus x1 is 80 and x2 is 125. Again x1 is 80. So after cancelling all those things, we are getting y minus 2,20,000 divided by 1,500 equal to x minus 80 by 1. After cross multiplication, we are getting the answer
y equal to 1500x minus 130,000 plus 220,000. Here y equal to 1500x plus 1 lakh. Okay, now we find the equation. Okay, after finding the equation, substitute the value of x in order to find the value of y. Here x is nothing but number of TV set, y is nothing but the cost of the TV set. So here the x is number of TV set, therefore here they are asking to find the 95 TV sets cost. Therefore, substitute the value of x equal to 95 in order to find the cost of 95 TV. So after substitution, we are getting y equal to 2,42,500, which is the cost of 95 TV sets. Okay. So I think there are here there are only 5 sums. So we finished these 5 sums in 3.2. You have to do the example sums in your note. Then only you score full marks, because 1/3 of the question paper consists of example sum. So concentrate on example sums also. Okay. So I am doing only the exercise sums. So example sum already you are having in your book. If you have any doubt, you may ask me. Okay. So there we are going to see the next sum in 3.3. That is, we are going to the next exercise 3.3. Okay, so the first sum is related to, if the equation ax square plus 5xy minus 6y square plus 12x plus 5y plus c equal to 0 represent a pair of perpendicular straight line, find a and b. That is, here one equation is given. They said that it represent a pair of perpendicular straight line. Find a and b. Okay, so the given a equation is ax square plus 5xy minus 6y square plus 12x plus 5y plus c. Comparing with this, the formula for the equation ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c, which is the equation perpendicular to the straight line. Okay, so if you compare the value of a equal to a and the value of 2h equal to 5, okay, because the coefficient of xy is taken as 2h, the coefficient of y square is taken as b, the coefficient of x is taken as 2g, and the coefficient of y is taken as 2f, and this constant becomes c. Okay, this is the way you have to do the sums. Okay, now the value of a equal to a, 2h equal to 5 means h equal to 5/2, and b equal to minus 6, 2g equal to 12 means g equal to 6, 2f equal to 5 means f equal to 5/2, and again the value of c equal to c itself. So the condition for perpendicular straight lines is a plus b equal to 0. Here the value of a equal to a and the value of b equal to minus 6. Therefore a minus 6 equal to 0 means the value of a become 6. So we find the value of a by applying the straight line condition a plus b equal to 0. Therefore, I am getting a equal to 6. Okay. Then next is they are asking the question, find a as well as c. Okay. So we find the value of a, but now we are going to see the find the value of b. Again, the condition for pair of straight line abc plus 2fgh minus af square minus bg square minus ch square equal to 0. So the pair of straight line means the condition, there are two conditions. One is perpendicular straight line a plus b equal to 0, and the second condition pair of straight line is a into b into c plus 2f into g into h minus a into f square minus b into g square minus c into h square equal to 0. Now substituting this value, that is the a equal to 6, b equal to minus 6, c we don't know, then 2 into f equal to 5/2, g equal to 6, and h equal to 5/2. Likewise, we are applying all the values. After that, we are finding the value of c, which is 1014 by minus 169. We are getting c equal to 6. That is, a equal to 6 as well as c equal to 6. So this is an important sum. The equations are perpendicular means we are applying two conditions. One is a plus b equal to 0. Another one is abc plus 2fg minus af square minus bgh square minus ch square equal to 0. Okay, now we are going to see the next sum. Show that the equation
12x square minus 10xy plus 2y square plus 14x minus 5y plus 2 equal to 0 represent a pair of straight line. Separate equation of the straight line, represent a pair of straight lines, and also find the separate equation of the straight line. So the equation is given as 12x square minus 10xy plus 2y square plus 14x minus 5y plus 2 equal to 0. Okay, compare this with the same, the in previous sum also we are comparing this, that is ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. If you compare this, we are getting the value of a equal to 12, 2h equal to minus 10, b equal to 12, 2g equal to 14, and f equal to minus 2f equal to minus 5. And then find the value of h equal to minus 5, g equal to 7, f equal to 5 by 8, minus 5 by 2, c equal to 2. So the given straight line represent a pair of straight line. Now apply the condition abc plus 2fgh minus af square minus hg square minus ch square equal to 0. So these things are similar in the previous sum also. So now we are applying these values, we are getting the answer is 0. So hence the given line represents a pair of straight line. So pair of straight line means there are two conditions. One is a minus b equal to 0, another one is abc plus 2fgh minus af square minus bg square minus ch square equal to 0. If a and b equal to z plus b equal to 0 means this is for perpendicular. Okay, so in previous sum itself I said it, perpendicular straight line means we apply that condition. Pair of straight line means we apply this abc plus 2fgh minus af square plus minus bg square minus ch square equal to 0. So we find this. Now they are asking find the separate lines also. Okay, so they are asking separate equation of the given line. Therefore now take this line, that is 12x square minus 10xy plus 2y square, that is the three terms in the p equation. Okay, which is equal to, after factorization we are getting 2x minus y, 6x minus 2y. Okay, here 12x square minus 10xy plus 2y square my plus 14x minus 5y plus 12 equal to, in the factor 2x minus y I am adding L, and the factor 6x minus 2y I am adding M. Okay, so after that we are comparing the coefficient of x and y both the side. Okay, what is the coefficient of the x in left hand side? It is 14x, therefore 14. In right hand side it is 2m plus 6l, that is 2x into m. Okay, the next one is 6x into l, we are getting 2m and 6l. Okay, then likewise here minus 5, y term is minus 5, and here my y term is minus y into m, minus m, then minus 2y into l. Okay, minus 2l. So you multiply by x term into l, x term into m, and again x term into l, likewise y term into m, y term into l. Okay, you are getting these two equation. After solving it, we are getting the value of l equal to 2 and m equal to 1. Now substitute these values in this equation, 2x minus y plus l, substitute the value of l and m here. So we are getting the separate equation like this, 2x minus y plus l equal to 2, likewise m equal to l equal to 2, likewise 6x minus 2y plus 1, that is m equal to 1, or the equation of the given pair of straight line. Okay, now come to the last one, that is show that the pair of straight line 4x square plus 12xy plus 9y square minus 6y minus 9y plus 2 equal to 0 represent the two parallel straight line. Okay, here it is that parallel straight line, and also find the separate equation. The same model you have to apply the condition. Okay, by factorizing, after that you have to add L and M in order to find the value. Okay, do it yourself. So students, Do all the sums in your assignment note. Okay, submit the note whenever we will ask. Thank you, students.